So I always put on the Swedish TV the first thing I do in the morning. My dad's first job was he had a fashion store. I would say what comes from my Albanian root has been my temper and my, you know, the strong will and the fighting spirit. It's like, it comes from within. The weather is getting better in Milan, so better weather, better moods. Every time I complain in training that I feel like it's cold, everyone always says, hey, you're from Sweden. But for me, that's the reason I'm not living in Sweden now. For the last 10 years, I've been living abroad. So last time in Madrid and now in Milan. So I feel like I feel more at home at the warmer places. What makes me feel at home when I'm abroad is probably trying to stay with some cultures that are from Sweden, what I grew up to. So every morning I wake up and I watch Swedish TV and that kind of things. It gives you that homey feeling. I value the mornings a lot. I'm a morning person. I wake up always early. I like to prepare for the game, eat certain hours before training to be prepared. So I always put on the Swedish TV the first thing I do in the morning. Otherwise, for me, home is not a place for me. For me, home is the people you love, and when you're with them, you can feel at home anywhere. Milan as a city, I like it. I mean, it's a big city, but it's also pretty compact, so it's always a lot of people on the move. Me personally, I like when it's like, I like to live in big cities where it happens, where everything happens, where it's a lot of people. I mean, the weather is good here, the food is good, or great. And it's a fashion city, which is something that appeals me as well. So I like the city. I'm feeling more and more at home in it. Just trying to find somewhere to live in Milan, and in every new city it's hard because you don't know the areas in the beginning, but then I always go with a gut feeling. So I visited a lot of areas in Milan, and then I went around Navigli there and I felt, oh, I like this place. You know, you have the water, you have full of life, a lot of restaurants, and I like that feeling when you just step out of the apartments and then it's a lot of life outside and a lot of things to do. I love the fashion, first of all. Unfortunately, I'm always away during the fashion weeks because it's always during international dates, so we're away with the national team. But for me, sometimes I just walk around in the city and instead of looking in the stores, I'm looking at the people. I like how they dress, the way they dress. It's like chic, elegant, and also a little bit unbothered style. You know, everyone has their different style and I like that part. So I like to just walk around the city and people watch and get inspired by different way how people express themselves throughout their clothes. Every time we have like a fitting with now with Milan, we've been with Off-White, for example, and then I've been talking to the people that work there. I was like, you have a dream job, just walking around and working with clothes, you know? It's, for me, it's like, it's so much fun, and I would love to be in that industry. I probably won't, because I'll always have football as a, I want to work within football, but it's also a big dream to work with clothes. I mean, I'm super interested in that, and also got a little bit from my parents. They were into the fashion when they were younger. They always told me, and they had like store where they always had this interest. So I think it comes from that. My dad's first job was he had a fashion store, so he always ordered the newest clothes and had just an eye for that. And I never asked him about it until like I got older and he was telling me about it, and I was like, yeah, that makes sense a little bit, you know, because I think it's a little bit in the DNA, and I also sometimes look at my parents. I'm like, you dress well, you know. They're like proper, elegant, and they know what fits them. So it comes from somewhere. I have a very strong connection with my heritage and the way I grew up. I learned the language because I was born and raised in Sweden, so I had a little bit hard time to learn the Albanian language. Obviously, we spoke it at home, but then my parents thought it was important for me to go to school and try to learn it. So I did that, which I'm super happy now because I like to. I feel close to my heritage and close to Kosovo, and I think it's important to know where your parents come from, because I don't think I would have been here today if they didn't take the decision when they were younger to move to Sweden and give me really good opportunities. So, but I'm proud of them. I'm proud of my heritage. I would say what comes from my Albanian root has been my temper and my. Now I'm very calm. Like, I think I really developed a lot, but I like that, you know, the strong will and the fighting spirit. It's like it comes from within, and I think it's in the DNA to never give up and having that fighting spirit. And that I can say comes straight out from my parents and from how they grew up. So I know it comes from there. And I see it also in my nephew and nieces that are growing up now. They have the same spirit. So I would pinpoint that for sure. I think everyone would laugh if I say this, but because I am very extrovert. I like to talk a lot. I'm very interested in people. But when I was a kid and growing up, I was very shy. So I think I have that mix of introvert and extrovert. But the older I get, I'm more extrovert. I think I'm a person with a lot of integrity. So it's not maybe easy for whoever to come close to me as a person, but extrovert in the matters of meeting new people and adapting has never been a problem for me. I think I'm pretty good at adapting. I never felt I had a hard time, except when I was young. My first move was to the USA. And then it was easy because I knew the language, you know, it was easy to get into the culture. But when I moved to Paris and no one spoke English, it was the same when I moved to Spain, no one spoke English. In that case, it was like harder to adapt in the way of being able to have conversations with your teammates. In Spain, I started to learn the language directly. Here in Italy, a lot of the girls speak some English, so, and my Spanish has helped me a lot to understand the meetings that we have, and the Italians and the Spanish are pretty similar to each other, so I feel like it's been easy to get into the Italian language in that kind of way. I think this is the life of professional players. I mean, you can't always win. You'll have seasons where things goes against you. But I think the more experience I have, I try to separate, you know, performances versus self-esteem. You know, when you're younger, when you didn't perform, you felt really, really bad as a person. When I was a kid, I was like, when I didn't win games, I was like punishing myself. I'm not worth to have a Coca-Cola after the game. I'm not worth to have a pizza. Or I was like that. I punished myself. And the older I get, I'm like, you have to separate performances versus self-esteem. You know, regardless the result, you're still worth as a person. And I think you have to find that balance in life for every professional player. When a game doesn't go well, I call home. I think that's a moment where you get back a little bit to your comfort zone and you want to talk to the people that loves you. And when I talk to them, I don't want to talk about football at all. This thing I always had with my family, especially with my family, I'm like, I don't want to talk about football. I just want to talk about anything else, everything else besides football. And so they know that even when I have success, I don't want to talk to them about, oh, what a nice goal or how many really nice performance, you know. It's nice to hear when they text me it, but they know that they should, when we talk about everything else besides football. The first time I went out of my comfort zone was when I signed for an American team. And I was, 19 years old. And I just took the decision. I think I didn't ask my family about it. I didn't ask anyone about it. I mean, USA is not close. I mean, it's far away. But for me, I always like to take my decisions through my gut feeling, like what feels right for me. And that moment I got the chance to play in the US, I just said, yes, I want to sign for them. And then I signed before I even told my family about it. So they make fun of me a little bit of it because they read in the Swedish newspaper before they knew themselves, because I was just like, yes, I want to do it. And then I just went for it. I like that. I mean, I am a brave person, but I was really brave in that young age to sign for a team in the USA. The first day I arrived in the US, it was more like a reality call. Oh my God, I'm here now, you know, because sometimes I just go with what feels right for me, and then suddenly I'm there and I'm like, okay, now I can prepare. So it was a way of stepping out of my comfort zone, but it was a really important step in my career because I felt like I wanted more experience. It was for me a dream when I was a kid to play in the US. So when I got the opportunity, I took it and I learned a lot from it. I'm not a person that stays in my comfort zone at all. I mean, I think it's nice to have a comfort zone, but I wouldn't have experienced everything that I've experienced, the countries I've been playing in, if I wasn't someone that took risks and took chances. And I think that's when you push your limits, I think that's where you learn the most. And it can be challenging, maybe it doesn't go well or you don't have success, but you always learn from those environments. So I think it's important to push yourself and push your limits and to learn something new. And for me, I think I have that mindset that I will never be fully learned. Like, I think every person you meet can teach you something. Every new environment can teach you something. And that's why I like to travel and get new experiences.